I'm Paul Offit, a director of the Vaccine Education Center at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia and a professor of pediatrics at the Perelman School of Medicine at the University of Pennsylvania. So for the 5 to 11-year-old age group, the so-called mRNA vaccine or messenger RNA vaccine that's made by Pfizer is given at a dose of 10 micrograms per dose as two doses 3 weeks apart. The dose that's given to the 12 to 15-year-old, as well as anybody over 16 years of age, is 30 micrograms. So younger children then get one-third the dose that's given to older adolescents or young adults or older adults. The trial that was done in the 5 to 11-year-old was a 2,400-child trial. So 1,600 got vaccine, 800 got placebo. The side effects that were associated with that were actually very similar to the side effects seen in adults, which is fever, sometimes higher fever, fatigue, muscle ache, headache, joint pain, transient, usually lasted 1 or 2 days and then went away. So similar to what was seen with adults. If you look, say, at the 16 to 29-year-old who's gotten mRNA-containing vaccines, primarily in males, primarily after the second dose, you see myocarditis as a rare consequence, usually in the vicinity of sort of anywhere from 1 to 20,000 to 1 in 40,000, depending on the age, the younger person being at greater risk. The good news is the risk was less in the 12 to 15-year-old, and now for the 5 to 11-year-old who's about to receive an even lower dose, I think it will be less there. Two. But remember, the virus also causes myocarditis. SARS-CoV-2 causes myocarditis. And also remember the so-called multi-system inflammatory disease, which is primarily the disease of that 5 to 11-year-old, is also a cause of myocarditis about half the time or three-quarters of the time. And that, too, is more severe than the myocarditis induced by the vaccine, which is transient, self-resolving.